So it's time to talk ladies Gaelic football. Donegal are of course heading into their final divisional game this coming weekend in Galway. Maxi Kern, Donegal senior manager, joins us to look ahead to that one. You're welcome to Highland Sport once again, Maxi.
Thanks, Ossian.
I suppose, Maxi, first of all, before we actually look at that game, two home wins, that was your target at the start. The girls successfully done that. Have you been impressed with how they have conducted themselves and through those two matches and picking up the two victories?
Yeah, look, the Westmeath game, first of all, was always going to be, a tricky one, a bit of a potential banana skin. We have a difficulty with Westmeath in the past. They beat us in the league last year. So, that was one we were just kind of worried enough going at it because you just don't know where you're at for the first game out. So we were, we finished the game well. We were probably quite wasteful in the first half and gave away a lot of possession unnecessarily, and that would have disappointed us. But look, they kind of stuck at it and kind of grew into the game and got better as the game went on, and then were, quite convincing in the end. And probably the scoreline didn't even do them justice. The Westmeath got a penalty in the last minute or two. Put a wee bit of shine on it for them. But look, going into the Mayo game, then that was always going to be a battle for us. And it was a game we were taken very seriously because we felt that, in the past our girls have played a lot of games against the bigger teams. With the big four, your Galways, Mayo's, Corks, and Dublins, and we've come away with moral victories and been valiant losers. And and that's something that these girls have got to sort out. They've got to start going winning these games. And that was the big thing about the Mayo game. Having the game at home was a good advantage to start with. And then after a shaky enough start, we worked ourselves into the game and grew as the game went on, and then finished the game very strong and probably full value for the victory. So that part was very, very pleasing, in terms of it's great to get the points, and after Westmeath you're probably safe from relegation. But then you turn your attention to the other side of the table and maybe making a league semi-final again, and we definitely put ourselves in a good position by beating Mayo.
Yeah. Have you been happy with the progression of the squad, Maxi? Because listen, there's been a lot of change. A few big names have gone out. There's a lot of younger girls have come in. Have they hit the level that you wanted them to hit over the last two games?
Yeah, look, it's something I've spoken about a lot. Having, a bit of experience with the county under 21s over the middle years there of the teenies there, you kind of had a different team coming every year, and you were starting from scratch, and you get to a senior inter-county team and you think you won't have that, but the transience of players is mad. We had of the 18 players we used against Dublin last year, there's eight of them not with us anymore. So it's a huge number to try and replace, and but it does give other girls opportunities, as we say, but you just maybe don't get the chance to have the continuity that you would have liked and then build on it, year after year. So but look, some of the younger girls that come in, the likes of Roisin Rogers, has been a revelation. She's had two great games. She was on after 10 minutes against Westmeath when Amy Boyle Carey got injured, and she started the last day against Mayo, and she's been very good. Annie Logue, so two very good games, two solid games so far. Susie White has come off the bench and scored on each occasion. So other people are getting their chance, and they're really making a go of it, and that's making the thing competitive. And fresh blood does revitalise everybody, and we feel that we have a good balance at the minute of younger girls and older girls, and it's a good combination.
Yeah, it's a good place you're in going into to the next game against Galway. First match on the road. Galway, of course, seen as one of the top four in the country. Maxi, what are you expecting this weekend? Obviously, Galway have won one. They've lost one. They're going to make changes for the game. They're not 100% got everybody available. But what's on the cards, do you think, for Donegal this coming weekend when they head to Tuam?
Well, look, it's, Galway have just got such a, such a dearth of talent. They have, they've minor titles and underage titles, over the years, so they're very strong at underage, and they've brought a lot of players through, and they're probably in a situation where they have they probably don't know what their best team is of that many footballers. But look, for us it's a game that look, we just need to win. There's no two ways about it, and that's going to be our approach. Some of our greatest days over the last 3 or 4 years have been sharply followed by some of our greatest failings, and that's something that we need to sort out. We can't be on this continuous peaks and troughs approach, you know, where we were brilliant one day and we fall down the next and then have to go back up again the next day. You know, that's just not what good teams do. And, you know, it's there's a bit of pressure on us. There's a bit of pressure on the Gaels of two, you know, big performances back to back against two big teams. And, you know, as you mentioned, Galway, you know, while they have a lot of really good players, as I say, there's a wee maybe absence of experience in this team at the minute, you know, based on what they've used so far in the league. So we feel it's a great opportunity for us. And, you know, as we consider ourselves to be in that top rung with the Dublins, Corks and Mayos and Galways, and, you know, we feel that we're capable of beating anybody on our given day. But as I say, there's a bit of pressure on. We've had a lot of good days followed by, you know, bad days and days that we didn't deliver when, you know, when we were, you know, expected to do so. And I think that's the situation we're going down the road on Saturday. It's not so much, you know, about the league points or the qualification, but it's more to, you know, just to show a bit of character and show that we can put performances back to back, and we're not just, you know, we're just not going to be flaky and, you know, have a good day followed by a bad day and then rise up again. So
yeah, the Gaels are of an understanding of that, Maxi. They're on the same sort of understanding level as you, and what is really needed out of the next game then.
Yeah, look, obviously qualification for a league semi-final would be great, and, you know, it'll be a really unfortunate twist, you know, to win your two games as convincingly as we did and then end up not qualifying. But that's the situation we're in. You know, Galway had a handsome victory over Westmeath last week, so they're now ahead of us in score difference. So if Galway happen to win the game, by virtue of them losing to Mayo and beating us, and us losing to Galway and beating Mayo, we'll all end up on 6 points, and then it'll come down to score difference. So that'll be the second time in 3 years we lost out in the semi-finals on score difference. But, you know, that's one aspect of it. And you know, you'll be facing a, you know, a really good semi-final against Cork, you know, another really good challenge. So that's what you want at this stage. You know, the championship's coming very, very fast down the track. So, you know, you want to be playing teams that are at the top end and really, you know, challenge yourself and see where you're at. You know, the winning and losing probably isn't all that important at this stage, but it's playing against good players, and that's where you find out about yourself. So we know coming down the road on Sunday, you know, win, lose or draw, we'll know more than we did going down the road. And as I say, it's just a big one for the Gaels. They need to step up, and they need to start showing a wee bit of steel, and they need to show that, you know, that they can do this week in, week out, and not just have these great days sparingly, you know.
Huge positives, obviously, Maxi, from the opening 2-1s. But if there's improvement needed, in what areas do you think you need to improve on if you are going to take that one?
Yeah, look, our unforced turnovers is killing us. You know, we're just giving the ball away, you know, very foolishly. And, you know, we'll go through patches of the games which show great maturity, and we'll keep the ball really well. And then somebody will just get a rush of blood to the head and possession's lost. And the good teams don't do that either. And that's the message that we're preaching all the time. Possibly our conversion rate up front isn't what it should be either, you know. The average in ladies football over the last 3 or 4 years has been a conversion rate of about 58%, and, you know, Dublin last year in final were 70%. You know, in the couple of games so far, we've been in the 40s, and that's just not good enough. And again, you know, for a team like us that, you know, that are in the chasing pack, you know, we need to nail those things down, and we need to take the percentages back in our favour. And, you know, when we're doing those things foolishly, we're not going to get to where we need to be. So, but look, the positive of that is that we know what we need to do. So, you know that the Gaels have a very clear understanding of what's needed on Sunday to, you know, to get over the line against Galway. And you know, and I think it's again a great opportunity for us to see what we're made of.
Yeah, the Gaels stepped up to the plate last week, Maxi, against Mayo without Geraldine McLaughlin. Will Geraldine be fit this week to play Galway?
Well,
any other changes?
We're not sure. You know, she's more chance of playing this week than she did last week. Aoife McCaughan picked up a bit of a hip injury early in the game, and, you know, it is quite remarkable. Aoife is naturally left-footed, and she played 3/4 of the game kicking the ball with her weak foot, and she had 100% retention on her kick-out, which is a fair achievement. I don't think many goalkeepers can, you know, could get through a game like that. So that's one wee concern for us, but hopefully Aoife will make it. And Geraldine, it's just a matter of time. She's just got a very severe dead leg, so she'll have to, just fingers crossed, that heals well in the next couple of days. But look, you know, lots made about Geraldine, and, you know, at the end of the day, you know, no team should be reliant on any one player. You know, you've got to give the boys great credit over the last couple of weeks. They delivered two big performances without Michael Murphy, and, you know, we managed to avoid defeat in both days and qualify. So, you know, we would feel that we need to do a similar type thing. You know, we feel that we're quite lucky in our forward department with the likes of Niamh Hegarty and Karen Guthrie and Niamh McLaughlin, these girls. You know, we're not just a one-man band, as I say. And while a lot of the tension goes on Geraldine, you know, there's an onus on everybody else to step up. And, you know, if we're dependent on one player to get us over the line, we're never going to get where we need to get them.
Okay, listen, Max, we wish you all the best in Galway at the weekend. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Josh. Thank you.